PAD stands for peripheral arterial disease, and it's basically the disease process where atherosclerosis narrows arteries to any peripheral artery in the body. The most common cause of arterial narrowing is atherosclerosis, which is where the arterial wall becomes thickened with a plaque caused by several risk factors. The plaque is usually made up of components of the normal arterial wall, muscle, and cholesterol, and then if the balance becomes overweight with cholesterol and triglycerides and overabundance of muscle groups, then the artery narrows, and that limits blood flow to whatever end organ that artery is supplying. The risk factors for peripheral arterial disease are age. It generally occurs in an older population, 70 years old or older. Diabetes is a risk factor for peripheral arterial disease. Smoking is a risk factor for peripheral disease. High cholesterol and high triglyceride levels are risk factors. And then a family history. Peripheral arterial disease can affect any artery in the body, but today we want to concentrate on peripheral arterial disease in the legs. And the symptoms people generally have with leg disease is pain when they exercise, that's called claudication, and then as the blockage becomes more severe, you can start having constant pain in your foot. And then the most severe form of peripheral arterial disease is when you have such a lack of blood flow that you can't heal wounds, and you develop wounds on your feet and toes that won't resolve. There's a lot of reasons why people's legs can hurt, and peripheral arterial disease is one of the most common, and it is also one of the most serious, and so it should be ruled out. The thing that we look for in trying to differentiate in between the different types of leg pain, with peripheral arterial disease, the pain is almost always associated with exercise initially. When we walk, the muscle groups in your rear end, in your thigh, in your calf, those are big muscle groups, and their requirement for oxygen and nutrients goes up a huge amount when we walk and exercise. And if a blockage is limiting the amount of oxygen and nutrients those muscle groups get, then you build up acid in those muscles, lactic acid, and that causes pain. It causes a burning pain. And so the kind of leg pain that is suggestive of peripheral arterial disease in its initial stages, in its more mild stages, are burning type pains in the large muscle groups, in the rear end, in the calf, in the thigh, and it occurs only with exercise. And it's usually at a definitive length of exercise or time of exercise, and it's very reproducible. It doesn't happen one time and not happen the next. If it's related to an artery, and it happens when you walk a quarter of a mile, it's gonna happen every time you walk a quarter of a mile. In the initial stages of mild claudication or mild leg pain with walking, a lot of times those are treated medically. They don't require an invasive procedure or a surgery. And medical treatments for leg pain because of arterial disease involve exercise. So we usually try to help a patient come up with an exercise regimen of walking a little bit more each day, 4 to 5 days a week, on a regular exercise regimen. We strongly encourage patients and try to help them in some kind of a tobacco cessation program where they can stop smoking, because smoking is a major factor in peripheral arterial disease. If we decide that a patient needs an aggressive treatment for an arterial blockage in the leg, that could include an angioplasty or a stent. They're minimally invasive. They're usually done as an outpatient procedure. Someone would come in, the procedure would take approximately 1 to 2 hours, and they would get to go home that day. A balloon angioplasty is where we blow a balloon up inside of the blockage, and it actually just enlarges the lumen, creates a lumen or the pathway for the blood to travel through that artery. But we have other options, including atherectomy, which is a Roto-Rooter type device, which actually cuts the blockage out of the wall of the artery and recreates that space that normal blood flow can travel through. We also have a laser that does the same thing, that opens up blockages and opens that space up the inside of the artery for the blood to flow. Ultimately, some patients need a surgery. They need a bypass where we reroute the blood flow around those blockages. That is an invasive procedure. It requires anesthesia. It's done in the operating room. It's done with actual incisions in the skin. So we have many treatment options for peripheral arterial disease, and we try to tailor that treatment option to the patient's symptom and to their risk of complication, their general health, and what we feel like with the patient that's going to be their best option to treat the peripheral arterial disease.